Hi, this is my favorite way to use a Morningstar.
The balls are the future.
Balls! I'm Arachne, and this is King Colossus. In a sea of hidden gems, this is actually one true one, and an underrated one at that. I really love this game to the point of giving it a 9 out of 10. Wanna know why? The game, for starters, was co-directed by Sega and a mangaka, Ojino Makoto, that died 2 years ago. You suspect that such a project would yield bad results, but it's not the case here. Because he also collaborated on the story and it shows. He did the best direction you can give to a top-down RPG and a pretty unique story. It starts typical with a character with amnesia, but the twists and turns will make you become a gladiator slave before you'll finally be able to find the love of your life and even marry in the end. Marriage in particular is pretty interesting because usually Japanese games leave that open-ended. Nice to see some story commitment here. But I wanna spend the most time on the gameplay, and in particular the weapon system. Because the rest of King Colossus is pretty typical. You get your light RPG elements like automated level ups, the works. Dungeons are the usual mix of puzzles, battles and traps, so I'm gonna gloss over that. But there's a pretty good amount of secrets, and since there are no guides for this obscure game, I'm sure I missed some stuff, but that's okay. More reason to replay it. Also, you can equip some magic for your mana use, even if it's not that important in the end. Various kinds of accessories, shields and armor, and the most amazing part, it all shows up on your character. Yep, you can see at all times what you have equipped. How it looks in the menu, it will look on you. It's pretty impressive and a great motivation to explore and find new stuff. But the weapons in particular are incredible. There are 5 weapon types and they all look and perform differently. Not only that, in the same category aside from swords, they also all have different functions. Yes, really, look at this for example, in the staff section, all different effects for each. And you wanna know what else is impressive? You can save in every place that is not an event room. Yep, you heard me right, saving where you want in a Mega Drive game. And it works. You start from the exact room you saved in, not at a specific checkpoint, right there. So what's the problem the people and the reviewers online have with this game? That's a fair question and I have an answer. The majority of negative reviews talk about how they die so easily against enemies. That didn't happen to me. But you know what I did? I never skipped a battle. I mean, it's only in real time, action RPG after all, they aren't gonna last long. With this simple trick, I didn't need to give more than 3 or 4 hits to any non-boss enemy. Why skip battles in an RPG without level scaling? Because the battles get boring to you? Then don't play a role-playing game. Pretty dumb otherwise. Oh well, their loss. Talking about bosses, I liked how every single one of them has a weakness against a specific type of weapon. If you die to one of them, just load your latest save and try another one, from swords to axes to bows to maces and stuffs. You're gonna find use for every single one of them at least once, even outside bosses, so it's impossible to get bored with so much variety. Experiment. You're gonna have fun. And don't worry about being overleveled for the final boss. It has 4 phases, so it's never gonna be very easy. I was lucky to figure out the weapons for each phase on my second try, but it might take you longer. Art style wise, I liked a lot of what I saw. There is just so much detail on the walls, enemies, characters, and sometimes even the floor. Plenty of varied environments too. Forests, castles, dungeons, caves, each with some themed look and puzzles to complement them. Pretty smart design. Musically it's not varied, but it's a short game. It took me 10 hours to finish it and I didn't know where to go. An expert at this game could probably finish King Colossus in half the time without dying. So it doesn't get the time to get boring before it's over. And what is there is pretty good. A mix of meaty sounding percussions and bass do the trick. I don't know how they fit in the whole fantasy aspect of this, but they do. They're not going in heavy with the guitar, so that helps. My favorite melodies come from the dungeon stuff, and that feels right. Because they are also the longest places in the game, and exploring with music that I whistled at times is really just great. So that's it. You know my vote on King Colossus. Go and play it. Go, go, go! If you wanna see me play the games that I will review plus some extra stuff, catch me on Twitch at ArachneRetro. Say a name that I use on Twitter where I will keep you updated with everything I am doing and more. See ya at the next review. Bye bye!